Getting started with FlexGrid for WinForms applications. Now that you have downloaded and installed ComponentOne WinForms Edition, let's begin working with the controls. In this example, we'll be working in a WinForms application with the ComponentOne FlexGrid. FlexGrid is one of our most popular controls and is an advanced data grid that enables features such as tabular data editing, sorting, filtering, grouping, and on-demand loading. It also features cell customization, data virtualization, built-in editor controls, and more. First, let's start a blank WinForms project and drag our FlexGrid control from the toolbox onto the form. An empty FlexGrid will then appear. In this example, we will utilize the smart tag at the top right of the control to connect a dataset and populate FlexGrid with data. The dataset used in this video comes from our Northwind dataset, included in our ComponentOne samples. You can download this dataset via the ComponentOne control panel. Some popular configuration settings also appear within the smart tag, and you can find a complete list of over 100 editable settings under the controls properties. You can change the FlexGrid style and behavior through the properties, the designer, our editors, or programmatically via our API and the code behind. When viewing the grid at design time, many users enjoy the ability to control FlexGrid's appearance and behavior through its properties and associated editors without ever having to write a line of code. The C1 FlexGrid column editor allows users to manipulate many features, including the grid's format, the font for each cell, the behavior of each column, and more, without leaving the designer. For example, let's format this column to display as a currency, rename this column header, and remove this column. If you would prefer to set the FlexGrid's properties via code that executes at runtime, then our vast API library is here to help. Many advanced features such as custom sorting, cell grouping, cell freezing, custom detail rows, custom cells, and conditional or value filtering can be implemented in FlexGrid by using our extensive interfaces and classes directly in your code. Let's try incorporating one of those features, cell freezing, into our application now. To quickly access the code behind for the controls, we can right-click on the FlexGrid in the form and select View Code. Then we can set the frozen columns property to true by referencing our FlexGrid object directly. With as little as one line of code, we can begin utilizing cell freezing to fit our needs. For more information on implementing and using these features, check out our documentation online, which includes step-by-step instructions, sample code, and complete API references. For more specific code examples, you can view source code directly in our C1 WinForms Demo Explorer. If you choose to install our samples through the ComponentOne control panel, they can be accessed directly in your documents directory under the ComponentOne samples folder. If you have any questions or issues during the installation or trial of ComponentOne, our customer engagement team is ready to help. To learn more about everything ComponentOne has to offer, continue with the ComponentOne Getting Started series.